Sir has previously held very, very important positions, some of which are the director professor and medical director GTB Hospital in UCMS, the director at Institute of Human Behavior and Allied Sciences, the director Rajiv Gandhi Super Specialty Hospital and regional director Health Services East. Sir is a general surgeon by training with specialization in trauma surgery, laparoscopic surgery, thoracic surgery, hepatobiliary, pancreatic surgery. Sir has a vast international exposure, such as at the WHO Fellowship for Laparoscopic Surgery in the UK and WHO Fellow for Trauma Surgery in Australia. Sir has been playing a key role in a number of medical and surgical emergencies of notable size, some of which are the dengue outbreak in 2015-16, the Delhi riots in February 2020, and of course the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. Sir has been the medical superintendent of GTB Hospital in 2015-16, and under his leadership, the Institute of Human Behavior and Allied Sciences achieved the third spot in the CAYACULP scheme. At the DGHS, Sir has brought about transparency and efficiency in the working of the DGHS. Sir is extensively published, has over 85 articles, including updates, reviews, and original research in national and international journals, and has been a strong proponent of the program-academia interface in all activities. We are so fortunate that he could spend a few moments with us today. And thank you so much, sir, for taking out the time today to join us. I welcome you for the inaugural address for this national webinar, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. I hope Dr. Sunil Kumar, as Director General of Health Services, first of all, would like to compliment Dr. S. K. Sarin, the professor, senior professor and director of ILBS. He has been instrumental single-handedly. Along with his team, he has led the whole team in making it possible. We in the directorate, we're happy to provide all possible support to him. It is basically he and his team which has been instrumental in bringing this program. And including this in the national program, the first in the country to do so, first country in the world to do so. So therefore, I welcome and compliment Professor S.K. Sarin. I also welcome, it's my proud privilege to inaugurate this national webinar on non-alcoholic fatty liver disease with the aim of focusing on the population level strategies for prevention of this particular entity being conducted today. It is definitely a proud privilege for me to be part of this program. It is an extremely important, extremely vital program for the government of India, for the public of India. As you all know, and you are the subject experts, we all know about it, that the non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is a major problem, not only the world, but also in India. This disease can progress through various stages, causing inflammation as well as tissue damage and leading into fibrosis, and finally leading into an irreversible damage to the liver, which is our master organ. Therefore, this disease cannot be ignored, as it does require liver transplant as the only viable procedure for the treatment if it advances to that particular stage. So not only the liver problems are there, but since it is the master organ, it also leads to various other cardiac related disorders in patients who are living with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. It can also lead to cancers, and the survival is definitely lower in patients with this kind of a disease. The treatment of or prevention of this condition is simply by means of changing the lifestyle. Today, it becomes very imperative on part of all of us to advise, advocate lifestyle changes, because it is a completely preventable disease. And all the misery, all the morbidity, all the health forces, engagement of the same can be avoided if we are able to play a preventive role for this particular disease. The progression of this disease can easily be halted as soon as we make the lifestyle changes. Because it is not an infective disorder. And therefore, all this information and how to prevent, how to go about preventing this disease were included in the operational guidelines, which were released on 22nd of February 2021 by our Honorable HFM. These guidelines have been developed by the technical leadership provided by the Directorate General of Health Services, the ILBS, the WHO, UNDP, and therefore this collaborative effort brings the best of the operational guidelines for the country. It is presented in the simplified form so that implementation of the same is easy, not only at the advanced centers where the experts already know or may be knowing about this disease. However, what is important is that simplified operational guidelines tend to engage and involve the district level doctors and below, who need to understand or who needed to be given operational guidelines in a very, very simplified manner so that they can effectively implement the same. These guidelines have been shared with all the principal health secretaries and MD of the National Health Mission, which has a deep penetration in our country. We also organized a webinar to sensitize the state and the district nodal officers of our national program to control the non-communicable disorders, which also included the faculty members from the various medical colleges from various disciplines. The media plan for IIC was also developed for integration and implementation of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease into our national program for cancer control, in collaboration with Ministry of Health, the WHO, and the UNDP. Today, I am a priority for integration into the program for national program for prevention and control of cancer, diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and stroke. It becomes a very priority work for us because it is completely preventable disorder. As of now, we have about 60,000 health and wellness centers operational, out of 105, 1,50,000 health and wellness centers planned for the country. Through this effort and through this extensive network of health and wellness centers, this program will be integrated into the already existing national program at the health and wellness center level. 569 medical colleges are providing the tertiary care besides many other apex institutions. From there to the health and wellness center, there will be a network for easy dissemination, easy integration of the program for the prevention of the non-alcoholic fatty liver disease into the already existing national program. I'm happy to share, as I have already told you, informed you that this program was adopted by our country, and we are the first in the world to adopt this and integrate this into our national programs for the non-communicable diseases. Because it's extremely important to prevent this disease, to detect this disease at the earlier stage, so that the patients do not have to go to the stage of transplantation only. If we control the diabetes, hypertension in a given individual and make some lifestyle changes, then this disease is completely preventable. And therefore, integration of this program into the national program for controlling these non-communicable diseases or lifestyle diseases adds to the wealth of country in terms of the health measures. We should also lay importance on appropriate physical activity, non-consumption of alcohol in any form, tobacco in any form, adequate hydration, balanced diet, prevention of obesity, in order to promote the well-being and prevent non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. The Fit India program is easily integrated with the other programs of the country in order to achieve the same. At the end, I'm happy to inaugurate the national webinar on non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. For this webinar, to the organizers,